So the first thing we're going to do is an introduction. And for this introduction, this is how to best talk to teenagers about what's going on. And it's important to note that our teenagers are troubled, they're confused, but most importantly, they're lacking information. Okay? Now, our role as advisors, as educators, we're not in the Hasbara business. We're not there as Israel's PR team. We're not there as Israel's publicists, or most importantly, as their defense attorneys. Our role is to educate. And by doing that, we provide facts, context, and perspective to help our teens navigate the complexity of today's Israel. That's really what we're trying to do. We're trying to help our teens navigate what is an incredibly confusing period of time, okay? In order to do this, it's so important to have nuance, because nuance is essential to helping our teens navigate Israel, okay? When we make things sound simple, when we paint things in a black and white picture, okay, it sounds to our teens like we're hiding information. And what nuance does, when we're providing both sides of the argument, what nuance does is it allows teens to process all the different information that they're hearing through our perspective, through our lens. Okay, so that's what we it's essential that we never paint things as, well, Israel's right, Hamas is wrong, Palestinians are wrong, and Israel's always just. By doing things like that, what we're doing is we're telling teens, your natural fears, your natural concerns that you have, your worries, your confusion is illegitimate. It doesn't make sense. And that's, first of all, it's wrong, because most of their concerns are justified. And what we want to do is we want to validate their concerns. We want to tell them that, yes, I even share some of your concerns, but this is why I am a fan of Israel. This is why I'm pro-Israel. It's why I love the state. It's why I love its army. Why I think it's right in this conflict. Okay? There is the biggest problem that we're going to run into are progressive catchphrases. Okay? Progressive activists, God bless them, develop new catchphrases that sort of substitute as a value system. And they use these catchphrases to demonize Israel. Okay? We need to recognize the catchphrases, recognize their connotations, and be able to use them and show how Israel matches along with these catchphrases, and Israel doesn't stand against these values, right? Israel is a very progressive country, although a lot of right-wing conservatives would like to imagine otherwise. It's not true. Progressives should be, unfortunately, they're not, but they should be Israel's biggest cheerleaders. So when you hear phrases that you don't naturally use, and we're going to go through some of them, but when you hear phrases that you don't naturally use, and you begin to hear them, often, and you automatic, reaction is going to be to push them off. That's not going to be the right way to do it. We're going to have to use those phrases to be able to argue on Israel's behalf. Okay? Okay, that is the introduction. Let's move on. Part one, skills. Okay? So like we mentioned in the introduction, you want to give both sides of the narratives, okay?